BBC Audio presents Albert and Me. First broadcast in 1977, series 1 and 2 of this comedy drama follows single dad Bryan Archer as he struggles to work and bring up his baby son. Starring Richard Beckinsale, Robert Lindsay, and Pat Coombs.
And then Daddy Bear says, "Oh, come on, Albert, cheer up. This is a good story. My dad used to read it to me. Except on Saturdays, then he read me the football results." All right.
"Who's been sitting in my chair?"
And Mummy Bear says, "Who's been sitting in my chair?" And Baby Bear says, "Stone me, who's chewed a hole in this page?"
Albert.
Oh, yes.
We present Albert and Me, starring Richard Beckinsale as Bryan Archer and featuring Pat Coombs, John Comer, Frank Thornton, Sharon Duce, Anne Cunningham, and Douglas Blackwell. As one unmarried father wrote to another, "Having a nappy time, wish you were here." In Bryan Archer's case, things are a little easier. His parents are only too pleased to look after their grandson. Well, sometimes they're pleased.
Hello, Mum.
Oh, Al Bryan. How are you?
All right, Mum.
Where's Albert?
He's asleep in our bedroom.
How's he been today?
He's all right, but it's your dad.
What is?
He weed on his football coupon.
What on earth made him do that?
No, Albert, not your dad.
Who is it, Lil?
It's Al Bryan.
I want to see him. I've a few words to say to you, Al Bryan. What about this son of yours, Albert? Do you know what he's done today?
I'm sorry, he weed on your coupon.
So she's told you?
Yeah, it's the first time he's done the pools.
Don't get funny with me. Not only did he ruin my drawers, he also got into the shoe cleaning box. I nearly had a heart attack when I saw him. I thought he was one of the black and white minstrels falling out of the telly.
Yeah?
And there's our cat.
Shall I make a pot of tea?
Do you mind? I'm talking about Albert. Our poor, illegitimate grandson and what he did to our cat.
What did he do?
He shut it in the fridge. We had to put Tibbles under the grill for 5 minutes before he could even meow.
I'm sorry.
But I'm telling you straight, we can't have Albert here during the day. He's your son, you look after him.
Well, I can't. I've just started this new job.
How is your new job, Bri?
Will you stop changing the subject? It's not fair on the little soul. He ought to be brought up proper with a mother.
Well, as far as I'm concerned, I am his mother.
With that long hair, you're lucky.
What is your new job?
I'm doing a selling course.
Oh.
I'm the only bloke on it. All the rest are women.
You see, women. That's all he thinks about. Don't forget, that's how you got Albert. Where you're going, I'll end up with our Camden Town calling me Grandad.
It was only once.
What are you selling, Bryan?
Cosmetics.
Cosmetics? I might have known it. A real Nancy boy's job.
Look, I'll show you. Look, can I interest you in a deodorant, sir or madam? And if I may say so, you need it. There's not a body odour alive can outsmell this. Watch. Yeah, hang on, that's carpet shampoo.
First your son wheeze on me coupon. Now you squirt shampoo all over me shirt. Now you've woken Albert.
I didn't.
Of course you did.
Shall I make a pot of tea?
Will you shut up about your rotten tea when I'm trying to have a reasonable argument with my son?
Oh, I'll go and see to him, poor little lamb.
Anyway, Al Bryan, I mean what I say. We can't have him here. What with your mum's back and my leg, it's too much. From tomorrow, you take him with you.
Good morning, ladies, and welcome to Cozy Cosmetics. Now, my name is Vernon Wordsworth, and I'm in charge of training. Now, it is I who will teach you the art of selling cosmetics, for an art it is. An art that ranks with painting, poetry, or music. Because it is your artistry that will sell our product, your gentle persuasion, that soft approach on your first entrance.
Morning.
Mr. Archer, you're late.
Yes, I'm sorry about that.
You should have been here 10 minutes ago.
Why, what happened?
Mr. Archer.
Sorry.
Sit down.
Right.
Be what, Brian? I'll move my bag off this chair.
Thanks, Anna. I'll just pick these chairs up.
Mr. Archer, will you please sit down? Here, near me.
Right.
You're ready now?
Yes, all ready.
Comfortable?
Yes.
Quite sure?
Yes, thank you.
Good. Just one question, Mr. Archer, before I resume.
Yes.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is that a perambulator?
Oh, this, yeah, dead right. It's a pram, all right. Clever of you to spot that.
On your way to a jumble sale, are you?
What?
The pram, Mr. Archer.
Oh, no, my son's in it, Albert.
I hope it is not your intention to keep him at work with you. The company doesn't allow pets or children. It's very bad for customer relations.
Ah, yes. Well, I mean, no, it's just for today. See, someone's going to look after him for me tomorrow.
Very well. For today only. Now, as we seem to be settled, in this session, I'm going to talk about our new perfume. Can anyone remember what it's called?
Dark Passion.
Oh, well done, Miss Jameson. Dark Passion, yes. The perfume that will transform an ordinary woman into a tigress with just one discreet dab. It brings out everything that is feminine in a woman. That hidden scent that draws men to her like a magnet. I'm sure you ladies understand.
Yes.
Now then, what is it that makes you attractive to men?
Well, I suppose it's my personal...
I was not including you.
Sorry.
It's the mystery, the dazzle, the exotic, the hint of fiery passion, the search for forbidden fruit. Mr. Archer, why are you wobbling that pram?
I'm just rocking Albert back to sleep.
Now, where was I?
Forbidden fruit.
Oh, thank you, Miss Jameson. Now, what comes after the forbidden fruit?
A cigarette?
Mr. Archer, selling cosmetics door-to-door is a very serious business. It calls for charm and subtlety, both of which, frankly, in you are conspicuous by their absence.
I'm sorry.
And your trousers aren't pressed.
Well, that's part of their charm and subtlety.
Mr. Archer, frankly, I didn't agree with your being taken on as a salesperson in the first place. Selling cosmetics is a very feminine occupation. I suppose you think you'll be up to it.
Don't worry about us.
Us, Mr. Archer?
Meaning one, me, you know, myself. I'm using the royal we.
Well, please let us know when you are finished and we can get on. Now, I should like to conduct an experiment. Picture, if you will, the housewife. Harassed, the daily chores surrounding her, piles of crockery, clothes to wash, the whole woman's world dragging her down. In this experiment, I shall play the housewife.
Typecast again.
Mr. Archer?
Yes?
You will be the sales lady.
Me? Oh, right.
Now, you are standing in front of a suburban semi-detached maison. For a change, you look impeccable. Even your trousers are pressed. You knock.
Right. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Chester.
Chester who?
Chester song at twilight. When the lights are low.
Mr. Archer, how dare you?
I'm sorry.
Sorry. Sorry. In all my years in ladies' cosmetics, I have never been so insulted. You've made a complete mockery of my lecture. You come in here, pulling a perambulator.
Pushing?
Pulling a perambulator. Then you make facetious comments throughout and sit there with your trousers unpressed. And now you perform cheap jibes on me. Mr. Archer, this is too much. I shall recommend your instant dismissal.
Oh, please, Mr. Wordsworth, give me a chance. I mean, well, I've got this very big little mouth to feed.
I cannot take the chance of your performing knocking jokes on our customers.
Oh, please, Mr. Wordsworth, I'll be good. And I'll sell. By the time I've finished, they'll be bathing in dark passion.
Well, all right, all right. One more chance. But if you do not make a sale tomorrow, then I shall insist to the company that your employment be terminated. Now, ladies, we'll break there for coffee.
Oh, thank you.
And, Mr. Archer, I'd be grateful if you'd remove your infant while we have coffee. I couldn't bear it if you started to change him while I was munching my water biscuit.
Right, Mr. Wordsworth.
And don't forget, no babies tomorrow.
Ah, don't worry, Mr. Wordsworth. You can count on me.
Good. Because tomorrow I shall be coming with you to keep an eye on your progress. A very close eye.
More coffee, Anna?
Oh, thanks.
Made a bit of a fool of myself today, didn't I?
Yes, you did. There's more.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.